it's Shartimus, bringing to you my very first installment of a brand new series on this YouTube channel that I am calling Marvel Legends Evolution, which is obviously inspired by the late Glenn Webb's action figure Evolution series. May he rest in peace and live on with all of us, because we all remember him, and what a great way to remember Glenn Webb through continuing on with his legacy in some sort of fashion. Now, I'm making my series very different from his. Well, not very, very different. I'm just focusing on Marvel Legends figures. He talked about all action figures related to a specific character. So I'm going to just focus on 6.5-inch scale Wolverine figures from Marvel Legends, X-Men Classics, and the movie figures. I won't be talking about 3¾-inch figures or 12-inch scale figures, nor will I be discussing import figures, and I definitely won't get into detail with other characters that have used the name Wolverine. We are focusing primarily on Logan / James Howlett / Weapon X / Wolverine. Man, I am glad I stuck to those restrictions. A lot of these are very cool. Some I'm going to keep, and some I'm going to resell on Mercari, which is a sponsor of this series. Mercari is a great place to sell your figures, man. I'm selling a whole bunch of my Wolverine figures over there. I'm selling extra Build-A-Figure parts that I don't need over there. I'm selling a bunch of Star Wars figures I don't need. So if you're looking to sell your figures, if you're looking to buy your figures, I bought a ton of these figures through Mercari. You can do it over there. App link in the description below. In just a week, I made $60. There's over 10,000 users that are making like $250 a week over there. So it's a great place to shop. It's a great place to sell your stuff. I highly recommend it, man. Now, the app is really easy to use, just to walk you through it really quick. You just hit the sell button right over there. I'm going to let them look through my pictures. I have some pictures of Captain Phasma, and I'm going to use those. Type in Star Wars Black Series Captain Phasma in the description. Brand new serious wear on packaging. And then hashtags, get hashtag. All right, I like that they have tags right there. You know, condition is new. Now for shipping, I personally don't like to do the free shipping thing. So, like for me, I have all my dimensions and weights figured out. And I really like that they have this cool USPS shipping program thing that works out really well. It's usually always just $4.99. So I'm going to save that right there. And then as far as my price goes, let's say $15. Because I don't think many people are really interested. There's also smart pricing right over here, which is really cool. So it can get negotiated down to $12. So hey, why not? So, all right, let's get this thing going. And it's all ready to go. At $15, I'll make $13.50. I think I paid about $15 for it, to be honest. But anyway, let's list it and boom, there we go. You can find me over there under Shartimus Prime, but I recommend you start your own account and whatever extra figures you need to sell, especially during these difficult times. You can find it over there in the description below. Check out Mercari. Download it now. Now, with that being said, for my action figure Evolution series, I'm going to try to present all these figures in a nice, consistent timeline. It's really tricky figuring out exactly when all of these figures came out, especially during the Toy Biz days. And they're releasing multiple waves throughout the year from different series. So it was pretty tricky. So we're gonna start this series all the way back with the very first Marvel Legends Wolverine figure that ever came out. And that is the 2002 release of the Tiger Stripe Wolverine, which was also my very first Marvel Legends pickup. That was the first Marvel Legends figure I actually picked up. Coincidentally, Jesse Falcon, the creator of Marvel Legends, is his favorite Marvel character as well. So, cool coincidence. And I gotta say, when I first saw this in the package, it was at the Redwood City Toys R Us. When I saw it in the clamshell packaging, my very first thought was, holy crap, Todd McFarlane is making Marvel figures now? What's going on? And, you know, I later saw that it had a Toy Biz logo on there. I just had my mind blown. I couldn't believe it. I had to pick it up. And, you know, as I look at it now, with this whole pre-posed torso, I could definitely see how I thought it was a McFarlane Toys figure. That's still going on to this day with the Kickstarter Spawn figures. But anyway, this blew my mind because it had this cool Hellfire base to go along with it. But I was able to get all kinds of articulation out of my Marvel figure that I was never able to do before. It just blew my freaking mind that I was able to get him into a ton of poses. I absolutely loved it, man. I mean, I just never had a figure quite like this, where it had all this awesome paint, sculpt, articulation, I mean, for the time, it was great. Now, you know, as I play with it, the articulation on the ankle pivot's a bit weak, but it had toe joints right over here, and yeah, it was large. I remember kind of being frustrated with it because it was such a large Wolverine figure, but later on, Toy Biz would eventually give us a smaller Wolverine. Now, one figure I did not actually buy for this whole series was the Unmasked variant, which was released at the same time. I didn't want the Unmasked version. I had no interest in the Unmasked version. At this time in my Marvel Legends collecting, it was really early on, and my mindset was I have one Wolverine. That's the only Wolverine I need. Now, one thing I did appreciate about this variant was that the jaw looked very consistent with the regular version. It wasn't enough for me to get it, but I always thought that was cool. So with me starting with my Marvel Legends collecting in 2003, I was really late. And it felt like I was late, because there's already two series ahead of that, and the Spider-Man Classic series. Two Spider-Man Classic series. So I felt like I was really behind at the time when I started collecting my Marvel Legends. In 2003, we got our Wolverine movie figures, and this right here is the superposable X2 X-Men United Wolverine figure, which was a huge improvement compared to the X1 movie figures. I only picked up the one that came with the motorcycle. That one right there, oh god, and I think that was like the main Wolverine figure body mold that they had used, and yeah. And even in X2, there's a ton of Wolverine figures that were not super articulated like this one. This one right here is the most articulated one, and it's not the worst figure in the world. It's not great either. It looks a little funky, but you know what? I'm happy to have it. At the time, I did pass on it because, like I said, I had a Wolverine figure already. And then there are two other posable Wolverine figures from this movie, X2 X-Men United. We got the Battle Attack Logan, which I like. As far as the design goes, very cool. And it came with a wolf. And yeah, this has a whole function thing where you can get the arms moving forward and back. This is back when Toy Biz would give us a lot of toy functions to go along with your figure. Still a very posable figure, very cool looking. I still like it, however the head sculpt does throw me off a bit. And then there's also the Street Strike Logan, which is based on the same function and the same feature, but this one came with interchangeable hands, which I thought was really cool. So it came with fisted hands, and then these claw hands with articulated fingers, and then fisted claw hands. So I thought that was really nifty. Again, I didn't pick up any of these back in the day. I think I just didn't like the head sculpts. I think the head sculpts is what really threw me off with them. But I think they're very cool looking, and now that I have them, I don't know if I could let these go. I don't know. Now, in December of 2003, Toy Biz gave us the X-Men 5-pack set that included the Series 3 Wolverine once again with a different head sculpt. So this one doesn't look as cool as the other one. It did come with an X base that you could put underneath it. Same exact body mold and everything as the previous Series 3 version, but we got a new head sculpt right over here, which I think is weaker compared to the Series 3 variant. But if you missed out on that Series 3 Wolverine, well, you had another chance to get Wolverine in that 5-pack set, which even then I thought was the weakest figure of the lot. Taking us into 2004, we got the X-Men Classics figures, which released a ton of Wolverine figures. First off, looking at this right here, this is the new X-Men Wolverine figure, the jacket that comes apart very easily. I did buy this online, and yeah, they did reuse this body mold later on, which we'll get into, but man, what a tricky figure to deal with. Now, I did like the Grant Morrison run on new X-Men, so I am happy to have this, and it just kind of represents a specific time in Marvel comic books. However, the jacket just makes things just really difficult to work with. It's really annoying. And then also in 2004 from X-Men Classics, we got another Tiger Stripe Wolverine figure. This figure came with a gun that you plug into his back, and it makes his arms move around and everything. Now, I had no interest in picking this figure up, however, I kind of wanted to because I thought it looked cool. I liked the head sculpt, and I liked the fact that it was a much smaller Wolverine figure compared to the Series 3 version, but I already had a Wolverine figure in my collection, and I didn't dive in and get this. And I think they re-released this figure with a Blackbird later on. So this was a very rare figure for a while, and I still think it is. This one actually cost me a pretty penny for as lame as I think it is overall. It has single-jointed knees, no ankle pivot, so there are things that are lacking with this figure. But still, just looking at it, it looks really cool. And the head sculpt is actually pretty awesome. In September of 2004 came what I thought would be the ultimate Wolverine figure of all time, and that is the Series 6 Brown Suit Wolverine with a brand new body mold and very stocky, very short, really long claws, incredible base right over here with the Muramasa blade. I thought that was really cool, but man, this figure was the one to get. I remember everybody going crazy over the Series 6 figures. That was a new hype for Marvel Legends. We had Cable, Juggernaut, Deadpool was in that wave. It was an incredible wave. The only weak one was the Frank Castle, you know, it was the Thomas Jane figure. That was the only one nobody wanted, but this figure was amazing, and to this day I still think it's a very good figure, and this has been reused numerous times, like especially by Hasbro, and we'll get into that more later on. And after that we got our Series 7 Weapon X figure, and this is a pretty cool figure as well. Now Hasbro has released their own Weapon X figure, which we'll talk about later, but this figure came with a really cool base. It came with a full Weapon X tank for him to stand in. You got interchangeable heads. The tubes all over the place were really awesome. However, they're known to break off and kind of get mixed up and ripped and stuff. So with all those tubes going on and everything, yeah, it was a little tricky to keep it in good condition. But I liked that he had really dirty fingers and really dirty feet. And I liked the nasty look of the figure overall. A very gritty Wolverine figure. It was one that I had in my collection, later on sold, which I had regretted for a long time, and eventually I just finally rebought it for this video. I was always a little disappointed in the helmetless Weapon X head. I feel like they could have always added a bit more hair, and luckily we do see that later on with Hasbro. And then now we move into 2005 with more X-Men Classics figures. We have Series 2 of the X-Men Classics, starting off with Ninja Strike Wolverine, which at the time I thought was cool looking but really weird, and he came with a whole mess of weapons which I thought looked really cool. I remember this figure tempting me. I saw it in package in the store once, and then I passed on it and then never saw it again. To this day it's a pretty rare and expensive figure. I really like the weapons a lot, and they are goofy. There's a bunch of blades and stuff, and as soon as you get Wolverine holding a knife while those knives are sticking out of his hands, you can see how stupidly redundant it is, but still cool at the same time. I mean, check this out. Look how stupid but fun this is. You get a three-pronged sword over here. Yeah, and I bought this recently, and it has a great looking head sculpt. This was sculpted by my favorite Marvel Legends sculptor, Dave Cortez, and out of all the sculpts I've seen him work on, I actually think this Wolverine looks the most like Dave Cortez. I don't know, but it does look like Dave Cortez, but I really like this head sculpt a lot. Very gritty, nice stubble and everything. Good looking head sculpt. That's one thing to say about the X-Men Classics figures, is that they do have really cool looking head sculpts. Just like the Stealth Wolverine figure that came out in X-Men Classics, this figure has a good-looking head sculpt as well. I really like it. Unfortunately, I did break the rubbery goggles, you know, so that sucks. He's supposed to have night vision goggles, and I ripped it. I'm so bummed out about that, because I did buy this new in package. Again, not a cheap figure. They did reuse this later on. I think Hasbro reused this for a Cable figure, and I just, you know, at the time, again, you know, these Wolverine figures are very tall. I feel like it's a very tall Wolverine figure, and kind of funny that he's got the, you know, the huge holster right over here for his gun and stuff. An interesting concept. I remember seeing this back in the day, and I had passed on it, but, you know, he's got butterfly joints, which is actually really cool to see from a figure from back in the day, and some decent ankle pivot here and everything. Very long claws. One thing that Toy Biz was notorious for was having the very warped, ugly claws. That's a very consistent thing with the Toy Biz Marvel Legends Wolverine figures, but still, cool figure, just not an absolutely necessary figure to have in the collection. And again, very awesome head sculpt. Jumping later into 2005, we have the Series 3 X-Men Classics figures, starting with the House of M Wolverine or the Airstrike Wolverine. I did not buy this brand new in package. I just got the loose figure like this because, hey, it'd be neat to have a House of M figure, but way too tall. I mean, this is at the time where the X movies were big, and I guess it was just kind of one of those things where we're trying to get used to Wolverine being a lot taller than he was ever supposed to be. But again, I love the head sculpt on this thing. I like the design too. It has this whole kind of pirate look to him, which is very different, and there's a lot of cool sculpted detail on here. I love the head sculpt. Once again, the X-Men Classics head sculpts came out great. And he has all these little features and stuff with the airstrike accessories that I'm not showing you. But if you want to watch Glenn Webb's action figure evolution video on Wolverine, and then I let Glenn explain most of the toy functions that happened with these figures. I'm not really going to get into that so much. Part of that Series 3 X-Men Classics, we got the XWC Chopper Wolverine figure, which came with a really nifty motorcycle. The gold and everything looks really cool. I like that design, and it just wasn't a figure I really knew about. To be honest with you, this one went over my head. At the time, the Marvel Legends series was kicking off doing amazing things. Like, the Sentinel series was out at that time in 2005, and that's where my attention really went. Like, the main Marvel Legends line was really doing really well at this time. But yeah, this figure, easy pass, but still not a bad looking piece at all. And the whole function, shooting a rocket from the front of it and everything, that's kind of neat. But I think the motorcycle bike with the chrome and all that, or the back metal mixed with the gold and the X Deco on there and everything. And then also in 2005 or maybe 2006, I could be wrong here, it may have been 2006 when these figures came out. Either 2005 or 2006, we got the Mutant Racer Assault Vehicle, which is Wolverine's car, which is just so funny that, yeah, Wolverine had a car, and this is where Hasbro took the Series 3 Unmasked variant and just repainted it. It's the same head sculpt as the Unmasked Series 3, just with the red and black colors, which I think is really funny. I don't remember seeing Wolverine with this particular design in any of the comic books. Maybe he did, maybe he didn't, I don't know, but very interesting choice for Toy Biz to release this. I thought it was kind of weird. I didn't even know about this until I was making this series. So there you go. Wolverine with a car. And now I have that in my collection, so I could put, my other figures in there. Who knows? I could come up with some ideas. The funny thing about this vehicle is that you could take the hood off over here and attach it to Wolverine's back. Yeah, so you take the hood off, and then you could attach these wings, and then you could attach these missiles, and then you could attach that to your Wolverine figure, and now he's ready to go, and you can have a flying Wolverine! Woohoo! And then getting to the end of 2005, we got the Marvel Legends Apocalypse Build-A-Figure Wave. And I remember when that hit shelves, it was like one epic day over here in the Bay Area where one Target store, the Ceremony Target store, got hit with a ton of these figures. And I remember everybody was talking about it. But I liked this figure. I like how small it is. And it's an astonishing Wolverine figure too. So having a specific Wolverine figure for a fairly recent for that time, being the Astonishing X-Men written by Joss Whedon, I mean, I just thought it was awesome. And a very cool wave, too. I love my Build-A-Figure Apocalypse figure. One thing I always thought was weird about this is how the belt split over here. Yeah, that always kind of annoyed me. But the alternate variant head sculpt with the unmasked Wolverine, that looks cool, too. I did pick that up recently. Didn't really want it so bad, but I don't know, right now I'm kind of glad I did, because I think it's a cool-looking head sculpt. Very cool-looking Logan. In 2005, we got the Legendary Riders series, and this was like my first not-favorite Marvel Legends line. Like, for real, there's a lot of things about this wave that I just didn't like, but one thing I did like was the Wolverine figures. Now, I'd only stuck with the Days of Future Past version, which is the regular version that comes with the motorcycle, which I thought was a cool addition. We didn't get a Build-A-Figure this time, but we got these vehicles, and I thought it was a very cool-looking motorcycle. I liked it. They did reuse the new X-Men Wolverine body mold for this, and it did come with a nifty variant, which I did pick up a lot later on. I couldn't find the hat for this video. Maybe by the time you're watching some of the footage, I did find the hat. And the jacket was slightly different in color. I remember the collar was a lighter white color. And you can see, he's got the wife beater on and the denim right over here. Looks really cool. I actually thought this was the cooler version. I don't know where the motorcycle went for this version right here. I believe I painted it to be a Captain America motorcycle back in the day. But yeah, the motorcycle did look a little bit different. The colors on the motorcycles were different between the two of them. For the record, I never once ever saw this on the shelf in any of the stores ever. So, in my eyes, this was always a pretty rare figure. Now we head into 2006, which was the year I really felt the most disappointment for my Marvel Legends. Now, the Legendary Riders wave came out in 2005. I picked up that wave in 2006. Wasn't the happiest with that wave, and we also got the Face-Off 2-packs, which were actually very cool. But when it comes to the Series 2 Face-Off 2-pack first appearance Wolverine and Sabretooth set, I did feel the plastic quality with Wolverine get a bit weak. The shoulder joints, you just can't move those in there, but I do like the design. Now, there is a variant to this one as well, where we have an open mouth. That was the same thing with the Sabretooth figure. You can get the open mouth variants, or you can get the closed mouth ones. I didn't actually spring the money for the open mouth variant, as I don't really want it. However, if I had to pick between the two, I'd go with the open mouth variant, just because it looks a little cooler to me. But not a bad figure, not a great figure. The plastic quality is very weird. It's a very hollow figure, so not the greatest Wolverine, but for a first appearance Wolverine figure, I liked it. And for the most part, I really did like the Face-Off 2-packs. We didn't see anything else come out until 2007, and this is the beginning of the transition of Toy Biz to Hasbro. Now, in 2007, the only wave we got from Toy Biz was the Walmart exclusive Giant Man Build-A-Figure wave, which was the first time I actually felt smitten by Toy Biz. I didn't like that this was a Walmart exclusive. I don't have Walmarts close by to where I live. I didn't then, still don't now. And it was very hard for me to track down this wave. Not only that, but the Weapon X figure had a variant, which was technically not a variant because it came with a separate Build-A-Figure piece. So usually in the past, it'd come with the same exact Build-A-Figure piece as the regular figure. But in this set, you had to get both versions. At the time, I hadn't read Age of Apocalypse. I didn't like that storyline. I didn't like that version of Wolverine. So I didn't want to pick either of those figures up at all, but felt like I had to because I needed to complete that Giant Man Build-A-Figure, which to this day is amazing. I love that figure. But in retrospect, looking at these Age of Apocalypse Weapon X figures, I like them. They're not too bad. They actually reused the Series 6 Wolverine, or most of the Series 6 Wolverine figure, for this Weapon X figure. So I thought that was cool. It's not a bad figure. Now, the burned head variant only lasted literally throughout one page in the comic. Like, throughout the whole series, there's only one page where he's really looking like this. Very quickly, his hair starts growing back. And the burned head version never retracted the stump claws. We only saw that, you know, later on in the book when the hair was all grown out and everything. You can swap those out if you'd like, but each figure only came with one version, stump or claws. The newer Hasbro version, which I don't have yet, that has the interchangeable stump. And that wraps up our Toy Biz era, and that wraps up this video for now. I'm closing things off with the end of the Toy Biz days, and next time we'll jump into, which is probably going to be part 2 of 3. I don't know if this is going to be a two-parter or a three-parter, but we will be getting into the early days of Hasbro, aka the dark days of Marvel Legends. So stay tuned for that. I hope you guys enjoyed this video. If you did, please hit the like button, hit the subscribe button, and the notification bell. Make sure you check all the links in the description below. I'll see you guys next time. Catch you later. Peace! Hey, I'm short of Miss Prime videos. Hey, you should click one. Yeah, click on one of them. Or subscribe if you haven't. We're shot.